People love bacon, and they love Costco. So people are going to love Costco's bacon, right? Turns out that's a more complex question than you might think. Here's the truth on the good and not so good about this bacon. The most important thing about bacon is, of course, how it tastes. It can be the most humanely produced bacon out there or the cheapest offering for miles around. But if it isn't tasty, it just ain't worth it. And the truth about Costco's bacon is that it is that good.
What do you think?
According to Consumer Reports, Costco's Kirkland Signature Bacon is better than most, if not all, competitor products, including well-known brands like Oscar Mayer and Trader Joe's. The Consumer Reports data found that, as compared with all of these other brands, Costco's bacon was the only one to be dubbed excellent. The report goes on to say, "It crisped up nicely and consistently, and had balanced fat and meat flavors complemented by wood smoke and a hint of sweetness." Costco's bacon isn't just better than other bacons, it's also cheaper. That shouldn't necessarily come as a surprise, seeing as a good deal is kind of the store's claim to fame. But did you know that Costco's bacon is a whopping 20% cheaper than comparable brands, according to the Wall Street Journal? This just goes to show that price isn't necessarily an indicator of quality. As a point of comparison, the priciest product tested by Consumer Reports, Oscar Mayer Fully Cooked Bacon, rated much lower than many other bacon brands. When it comes to bacon, Costco really does put you in bacon heaven. No sacrifice on the quality required. Given Costco bacon's low price and high quality, it's perhaps no surprise that it's one of the store's best deals. Today rated it one of its top Costco options, bemoaning nevertheless the sheer quantity of bacon one must buy to reap the rewards. At Costco, consumers are required to buy 4 pounds at a time in order to reap the benefits of this deal. Of course, that's not necessarily a bad thing. Costco sells its bacon not as a 4-pound behemoth of a pack, but in 4 far more reasonably sized 1-pound packages that are merely sold together. This makes it easy to open just one at a time and freeze the rest. Because do you know what defrosts beautifully in the fridge? You guessed it.
Bacon.
It's delicious, it's cheap, there's gotta be a catch, right? Surely Costco's bacon can't also be humanely produced? Honestly, Costco has been pretty good on that front too. And it's not that surprising when you know a bit about Costco's humane and sustainability commitments. Costco has a history of taking a stand on animal welfare and environmental issues, vowing back in 2015 not to sell GMO salmon or caged eggs, both of which were decisions that spurred similar commitments by smaller retailers and, according to Organic Authority, essentially changed the market demand in one fell swoop due to the sheer volume of merchandise moved by Costco. When it comes to its bacon, Costco applies the same animal welfare standards it applies to all of its meat and dairy, supporting the 5 freedoms of animal well-being and relying on trained auditors to make sure that these and other criteria are respected, such as controlled use of antibiotics. Costco sells several types of bacon, most of which are marketed under its Kirkland brand. But there is one exception, the store's Hickory Smoke pre-cooked bacon, which is made by and branded as Hormel. According to Costco corporate buyer Sarah George, the decision to work with Hormel for this product came after quite a long time of seeking out an appropriate bacon supplier that was of the quality Costco required. George tells Supermarket News that when she couldn't find a bacon that met the chain's needs, she reached out to Hormel, asking them to manufacture a product just for Costco. This pre-cooked bacon is different from Hormel's pre-existing product, in that it's sliced a bit thicker. Of course, despite being delicious and inexpensive, Costco's bacon isn't totally perfect. One gripe quite a few consumers have is the lack of uniformity, specifically the company's penchant for hiding broken, thin, or fatty bacon pieces in its packages. It can be hard to see these pieces when you're picking your pack at the store, but as soon as you get it home, it becomes clear. Not only is it tough to separate the slices, but once you cook them, not everyone at the breakfast table is going to be getting the same size or quality of slice. To combat the issue of small, fatty, broken pieces that consumers have been finding in Costco bacon packages of late, Insider found a solution to ensure that you're always getting the best slices of bacon when you buy it from Costco. Offer the thick cut option. This style of bacon is meatier and cooks up more evenly, according to Insider. And considering that the product costs just 30 cents more per pound than the regular bacon, it's worth it. At least according to the Insider reviewer, who writes that from now on, that's the variety she'll be snagging every time. Despite the time-honored tradition of frying bacon up in a hot skillet for your breakfast or brunch, an Insider's review of both Costco's regular and thick-cut bacon, the reviewer found that cooking the bacon on the stovetop rendered an unevenly cooked, shrunken, and even burned final product. On the contrary, bacon in the oven is cooked up more evenly with slightly less shrinkage, a benefit the reviewer said made the slices appear meatier. And cooking bacon in the oven has another advantage. It's far neater than a sizzling, spitting skillet of grease. In fact, the New York Times recommends banking on baking your bacon. Doing so will give you evenly cooked slices, and you won't have as big a mess to clean up or have to deal with potential grease burns from an angry skillet. This method, the outlet adds, is also ideal if you're going to be cooking lots of bacon for a large group. What was once a well-kept secret is suddenly surging in demand, not just because people have finally gotten the memo on just how good Costco's bacon really is, but because pork prices across the country are climbing. Costco's bacon is therefore becoming more and more sought after by consumers who want good quality bacon at a reasonable price. Factors pushing pork prices higher, Fox Business reports, include herd losses linked to diseases like porcine reproductive and respiratory syndrome, as well as African swine fever. For as long as these ailments plague the pig population, pork prices will probably continue to rise. Check out one of our newest videos right here! Plus, even more MASH videos about your favorite foods are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.